got one that can see.
We all know that we cannot keep our people safe, we can't keep our police officers and their families safe, if weapons of war continue to flood our neighborhoods.
Joining us now, we have the governor of New Mexico, Michelle Lujan Grisham. Governor Grisham, Lujan Grisham, thank you so much for joining us. What struck me out of that report was that so many shots were fired that there were people in the neighborhood who thought there were multiple shooters, which gives you a sense of the impact and the terror that these assault weapons rain down on communities when they're being used. 190 bullets discharged by the shooter, a cop shot, three dead. What do you think you can do on the state level to try and attack this problem?
Yeah, we're going to have to do everything. And Micah, it is. It is horrifying. And we've asked for a complete ban on assault weapons. We're putting $600 million out into behavioral health. We put $40 million out into additional school security and safety. And all of it, more needs to happen. There is a gun violence, a gun culture, and an anger problem in America and in New Mexico. And we're now going to take our crisis response teams and keep them in place until an entire community could be forever. We don't stop investing in these communities. And I think that has to be part of the sets of solutions.
It appears to me that there needs to be sweeping action to help all of our young people across the country when it comes to mental health. I think our kids are really suffering in this case at an extreme level. This gunman left this note that we saw in the report. He was ready. He had a bulletproof vest on that he enhanced. But where would he get an AR-15? And how in the world should an AR-15 be in his hands?
Shouldn't. This is my point exactly. Frankly, no one that isn't in the military, this is a weapon of war, or the trained police department. In my view, no one in America who isn't in one of those two situations should own an automatic weapon.
Santa Fe County Rep. Andrea Romero is behind the proposal. According to her bill, assault weapons are generally defined as semi-automatic shotguns, pistols, or rifles. Assault weapons are generally defined as semi-automatic shotguns, pistols, or rifles.
Shouldn't. This is my point exactly. Frankly, no one that isn't in the military, this is a weapon of war, or the trained police department. In my view, no one in America who isn't in one of those two situations should own an automatic weapon.
They are generally defined as semi-automatic.
In my view, no one in America who isn't in one of those two situations should own an automatic weapon.
What you just said is one of the most insanely idiotic things I have ever heard. At no point in your rambling, incoherent response were you even close to anything that could be considered a rational thought. Everyone in this room is now dumber for having listened to it. I award you no points, and may God have mercy on your soul.
In my line of work, you got to keep repeating things over and over and over again for the truth to sink in, to kind of catapult the propaganda, to kind of catapult the propaganda.